I'm in the old school 84 Delta 88 with an ounce, but I'm bouncing like I'm out here moving weight. Boning bigger in the Pioneer as I reminisce. Before that, it was the Eagles, took them back in 96. Yeah. I went down to Houston for some face. Mary Jane with a coincidence. I'm blowing swooshes, doing the same things.
Hey, what's up, everybody, man? It's Black Sean, man, from Street Culture Entertainment, man. This is Street Culture TV, and I come to you with a new video, man. Before I start this video, I need y'all to like and subscribe. And I also need you to hit the notification button so you can get notifications when I drop a video. Also, I want you to leave a comment for me, man, so y'all can chop it up with me about the situation. With that being said, let's do this shit. ESPN just fired former NBA player Paul Pierce. If y'all don't know who Paul Pierce is, he's a former NBA player, man, that played for the Boston, most known from playing for the Boston Celtics. He was a 2008 champion, 2008 MVP. He was a 10-time All-Star. He won the three-point contest in 2010. His number 34 was retired by Kansas Jayhawks, his college team, or whatever. But he was fired by ESPN because on Friday, I believe that was Friday, he went live at a poker game at his homeboy house. And at the poker game, it was women in the background dressed in bikinis that was twerking and dancing, basically stripper style. And there was one that was rubbing his back. And he was smoking a cigar. And they alleged that it's marijuana, which I doubt it is. Because I don't think he'll do that on camera. Now, my problem with this is, I can see it both ways. From ESPN's end, I see it like they're a business and they want their employees to present themselves a certain way because everybody knows who these people work for. Everybody knows when they see Paul Pierce, oh, he used to play basketball. He an analyst for ESPN now. Everybody knows it. So I feel them as employers. They want their employees to present themselves a certain way in public and shit so that it don't reflect back on the company. So I can understand them on that note. But on Paul Pierce's end, I can understand him because he's been playing basketball since he was a little boy. He accomplished a lot in high school. He accomplished a lot in college. He accomplished a lot in the NBA. But he never had time to sit back and enjoy the fruits of his labor like he wanted to. You know what I'm saying? Just freely and easily. Now that not like now while he's retired. You know what I'm saying? So I understand him on it. Secondly, I don't even much think there was no goddamn weed that he was smoking. I think that was a big old ass cigar because I can tell by the smoke there wasn't no damn weed. But when you did go wrong, at Powell, you shouldn't have recorded the shit yourself and put it on IG, bro. You shouldn't have did this shit. Now, if you were just doing this shit and somebody caught you on camera while you was doing it, then that's different because that's your private life and somebody just happened to record it. But you put it out there for them people to see. And I'm pretty sure you expected some kind of backlash or you knew it was going to be some kind of backlash for it, bro, because you know how they do us. You know how they do us. We do something simple like that and they ready to fire us or put us out the league or whatever. But motherfuckers like Ben Roethlisberger catch a whole rape accusation, two of them, matter of fact, and they get swept under the rug. You never hear about it again. So you should have knew it was going to be some kind of backlash. But this is what bothers me. Chris Broussard said he feel like it's hypocrisy because Paul Pierce could have had a TV on with the Grammys panning in the background and you would have seen the exact same thing that on the TV that the girls was doing behind him. Why should we have to hold him to a high standard when you got sexual suggestive stuff on primetime TV for kids to watch? I ain't talking about like no shit you got to push in the caption, you got to push in the code to get in, or no shit you got to push in a cable box to get in or whatever, some hidden shit. I'm talking about this shit on primetime for them kids to see. But they want to trip on him. They want to trip on Paul Pierce for that. I don't know, man. I guess it's just how the game go, man. I'm Black Sean Groove, man. I approve this message. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. Hit the notification, man. And y'all go ahead and comment for me, man. Let me know what y'all think about this, man. Because I think this is a fucked up situation, man. But I salute Paul Pierce, man. Have fun. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep on smiling, man. I'm going to holler at y'all.